big part of picking heroes that they're more comfortable with, and as well as taking it away from the other team. I mean, I think the SF ban is targeted towards RTZ, the Weaver ban is targeted towards Mason, because last time, or it seems like every time we see Mason play, he's either on a Weaver or a Mirana, or they lose the game. So...
But if he doesn't play any hero...
I like how there's just no gray area.
There's no gray area. Like
he's like Mirana, Weaver, or lost game.
Yeah, pretty much.
He played Storm a few times too, right?
Yeah, he
did
quite
lost
well.
The game.
It's like, no, yeah, that's
no, I'm just speaking that one out of my ass. I'm not sure about that. But remaining. I remember he was playing an Aura Carry Venge in the Dream League.
Oh, yeah.
And it didn't work well for them. But in any case, we're going to see Arteezy OD.
Reserve time.
Probably Midas first. Another gankable hero, would you say, Andy?
Gankable, but not as bad as like an SF or a Tinker. Like, those two heroes, in my opinion, are like the easiest ganks in the world.
But looking at Team Liquid's lineup, who is going to gank OD?
Well, the thing is, that's part of the reason why you don't pick your mid so early.
Yeah.
Because that way, first off, the other team can't counter it, and the other team can't decide if you're going to be more passive with your lanes or not. I mean, seeing a Batrider, a Nyx, and a Bane, it kind of says, sure, the lanes are going to be static for some time, but as soon as the Nyx hits level 6, you're going to start having roaming. Bane could potentially roam, but they don't have high damage. And even with an OD mid, you're not going to get points into your orb until at least, like, in my opinion, 8 or 9.
Yep.
Like, that's minimum when you would start getting it. Otherwise, you're not going to have enough points into Banish to get base damage, and you're not going to have enough points into Essence Aura to make sure you can sustain your mana.
Ooh,
so you're going to need, like, both, I think.
The good old counter.
Yep.
Razor.
I think Viper is a harder counter than Razor, personally.
Now that the corrosive skin allows you to pass and take the poison damage,
and the fact that even when you cast Astral Imprisonment, you get the damage.
Yeah, from corrosive skin.
Let me ask you this.
Okay.
Does the damage actually win him the lane if he gets banished, or does the base damage discrepancy between the heroes still make it so OD out CS's him? Because if I'm looking at the matchup and I'm thinking to myself, if he imprisons me, and I have a Link, and I drain like anywhere from 14 to like 28 damage, then the damage he gains from his imprisonment is negated.
Yep.
And I actually still have higher base damage than him, which means he can't trade.
Yes.
He doesn't have 600 range. So I can still like out CS him at that point. I think that's really OD's only laning strength. It's just the capability of CSing.
But on the other hand, when you go against a Viper, let's say the OD uses the imprisonment to get intelligence. Now, for the next 12 to 16 seconds, he's just very easy to harass for the Viper. He just like orb walks you all the time.
You can't orb walk if you have no mana.
Well, I mean, realistically, he'll have enough mana for an orb.
I mean, the other thing to factor in here for the Viper is he also has corrosive, or whatever that other path
is. Nether toxin
makes it easier to last hit.
Easier, but, you know.
I mean, it goes up to 32 extra damage at level 1.
Right, but at that point, like, creep is so low in HP.
I thought it was 40 now.
It might deny it.
Yeah, but it doesn't really matter.
Oh, well, I can see Viper now.
Yeah. Oh, they're going to win game. Mason Mirana.
Okay.
It's been called.
And they have multiple ways to set up arrows, man. They have Imprisonment, they have Nightmare, Fiend's Grip, Lasso.
How's a Lifestealer going to attack anybody? Like, you have OT Imprisonment, you have Fiend's Grip, you have a Lasso, you have Leap defensively.
I think that's kind of what the clockwork is for, to be honest. I think it has to be like an end into the clockwork. Even though the Mirana has an escape and the Batrider can lead his Firefly, that still leaves Bane, OD, and Nyx that you could potentially go on, although I will say that the OD can still counter that kind of initiation by just not being the one who's initiated on, you know, because you can just imprison whoever else gets caught. But if you get caught, it's going to be rough.
ODs usually get an early 4 stuff as well, which is really, really good against Clockwork.
Well, RTZ is not getting an early anything except Midas, because that's all he does.
Question to you. Do you remember if you lasso someone and you disrupt that person, you still take the disruption
with you?
Yeah,
with
it
you.
Still drags it.
I would assume it works the same way for
Astro. I think that shouldn't happen, by the way.
You think you should just stay where you are when you get imprisoned?
You're out of the map.
Sense.
Yeah.
It's like you're not even in the same dimension anymore.
Right. Why am I?
How could you be getting moved? No,
but if you move,
I agree.
If you move the dimension gate, like surely you have to come through the same gate.
If you walk into a Stargate.
Yeah, and they move the Stargate. Like, this happened in Stargate a few times, actually.
Okay, to be fair, you're right. When you're right, you're right. But like speaking in Dota terms, if you arrow into a Stargate,
yeah,
the arrow comes out on the other side, right? But
It's like teleporting on a creep.
Unless you turn off the Stargate, then it has like a certain amount of time while the Io's in space, so...
Okay, I don't even know where I was going with that, to be honest, but...
I've watched a lot of Stargate.
It looks like Demon's gonna be playing support, though, for Liquid.
Yeah, I mean, he has been playing support for the...
I mean, he's playing offlane quite a few times.
Yeah, it didn't work, so they...
He's like, no. He's like, nope.
They tried him, like, a
Centaur?
Couple times.
Yeah.
Because honestly, like, nothing against Demon. Ooh. Boba as well as Koifa is just stronger solo players than Demon.
30 seconds.
Oh, he's walking headfirst into high ground. The comms from Boba! That's a guaranteed death.
Oh, he's gonna dodge himself.
A really nice stun from Zai. It's 4.
Koifa got the kill.
So normally you make that kind of roam when you feel like you have the stronger level 1, which is very debatable in this particular matchup. Yeah, Chen is a weak level 1 hero because he doesn't have a nuke, but when the cogs hit the right way that Boba forced it to hit, the level 1's all in the favor of Team Liquid.
Going up into the darkness like that is so bold.
I mean, it's a common move to make against a team with a Chen.
Walk up straight like into the darkness?
Well, they shouldn't have walk up the cliff.
I mean,
like they did.
Like, in his defense, that is like literally the only way he could have died.
Yeah.
Is if he got cogged like that. So I kind of get why he felt safe. Because even if he gets open wounds, you know, he can just wait for the rest of his team to back him up, throw out an arrow, maybe bait a fight and get a kill back at least, you know, if he dies. But because he got cogged on the high ground and no one else could walk up the hill, that is like, that is his death.
Yep. And you would argue that actually forced Razor to go for Link, or sorry, Plasma Field, so he doesn't have Link to level 2. Koifa is just straight hit on
He has a bottle on the way soon. So
that is
like...
true, though. It's actually a boots first on Razor, which is very, very common in this particular matchup.
The boots are important to make sure that with the lower levels of imprisonment, like depending on, I think it's 550 range now on Astro.
They reduced
it
recently by 50.
So basically, if it's a rank 1, you could probably still stay in range. Universe pretty low top here.
He's Regoosing.
He's got level 1 boots as well. Seems like this is the game of level 1 boots.
If I did that in a pub game, I'd get abused to bits.
Ah, it's good though. People underestimate boost speed, man. Shoes are good. You ever try walking outside without shoes on?
I went there this
that
morning
shit
actually.
Sucks.
To check the mail.
It's not good.
Stones everywhere.
Even just walking to the mailbox hurts.
Yeah.
Alright, so.
That's a good segue.
I'm just saying.
No, it's a fact, like.
It's a fact.
Tried walking around without shoes on.
You don't wear socks generally, though.
No, I don't. I mean, that's only because I ran out. Oh, you know what? I actually went to Centrum yesterday. I could have bought more socks.
I need socks as well. Next time you go, socks.
All right, so Koifa, despite getting that first blood, he's actually not doing so hot right now against RTZ.
Bottom. He's got bottom.
Yeah, but I mean, does,
maybe give him the rundown.
Does having a bottle win him the game?
The issue with this particular skill build, he's gonna get a ton of damage. I'm surprised that Wauken didn't go for the body
that
blocks.
Link, man.
Yeah, man.
Yep.
With the body block, would have definitely got the first blood or second blood.
Yeah, but that would have been a pretty tall order. That OD has boots.
Hey, man.
He's 365 move speed, man.
What do you lose by not
he's
being a body
block? He's actually faster than Koifa because he has no points.
Not when he's not body blocked.
Well, okay.
I'm just saying, what do you lose by going for the body block?
He just wasn't paying attention, man.
Fluff wouldn't pay attention.
No. Maybe he was looking at something else in the woods.
Whoa.
Nah, I'm just...
Way too sexy, just so busy being happy.
Yeah, that's... Just giving it way too a tough time.
Yeah.
Way too's a good lad.
There. He's not there yet.
Way too, or could it be way too as in he's too sexy, or could
no,
be...
because that would be T-O-O, not T-O. Like, way too sexy is like he's on his way there. As in it is the path too sexy, not I am way too sexy.
I think that's what he's trying to say with his name.
Yeah.
Okay.
There you go. Naming 101 here at the Dream League. Because it's, let's be honest, it's not a whole heck of a lot going on. But we can talk about like who we think's getting better at the situation. I would personally say that given the first blood, like Koifa started to make his way back into the lane, which sounds weird to say, given the one that he's got the first blood. But it's actually fairly hard to land against OD, even as Razor.
He also shared the experience between 5 people, so he didn't get like too much of an experience.
Oh, are we gonna see open wounds? No.
Big even with an open wounds, it's very, very hard to kill him in that position.
Yeah.
Because you can just Firefly and just abuse the high and low ground right by the river. Or heck, you can just fly off the map if you want to. Just take a vacation.
Man, he's got 6 here. Armor with Tranquil Boots, so I don't think he's in trouble. Like, if he does armor based on damage based on armor. Let's see if he's gonna get this last hit, which is gonna be big. Nope. Demon.
Has Koifa learned his passive yet?
Yeah. That's another thing that you kind of need to do against an OD.
Which, getting the nuke at level 1 actually delayed him quite a bit.
Yeah, that's what I was...
Kind of torn as to, like, the level 1 nuke in a 5 versus 5 versus just getting a point into static link. Because no one on the side of EG is going to have an escape at level 1.
Batrider.
Well, I mean, sure, but would you lasso, or not lasso, would you link the Batrider? Like, if the clockwork, or not, excuse me, not the clockwork, but like the Nyx were coming up for a stun, or the Bane was coming up, like, you should be able to realistically get like a good 5 or 6 second drain on them.
Yeah. Boots first would have gave everybody the rundown.
Yeah.
Arteezy though, man, he's not going to be denied. And bottom lane, Mason just gets to pretty much refarm.
You can't phase boots in this case. Would you go for a Midas first, or do you think getting phase boots first is always a good idea?
I think phase just allow for better lane last hitting. And I think that Morana's animation is actually pretty decent. I know a lot of people don't like it, but...
I hate it, personally.
I think it's pretty good. Well, I think it's one of those things that you gotta get used to.
I think even if you're going for Midas, you should still upgrade for the phase first. Because how the creep equilibrium works in the new patch, if you just go for the greedy Midas, it basically allows the enemy off lane to actually come up to the lane, because you don't have the lane dominance that phase boot gives you. So you should go for phase, even if you're going for Midas. If you want to be greedy, then you just stay at the regular boots. But
I guess that makes me not as greedy as I thought, because I always get phase before I get Midas.
This is a very, very safe Midas build.
I think it depends on the game. Sometimes I go...
I mean, if you get a first blood, then you, like, you know, get all the last sets in.
Whatever.
Go Midas.
And it's just like, YOLO, no boots, Midas.
Yeah, sometimes I do.
It can be good in situations where you know the other team doesn't have any way of pressuring you.
Yeah. Or TV.
Most of the time, I just don't really care.
So what do you think the first major item we're going to see from Poifa? Are we going to see a quick mech, quick drums, straight point booster?
I think Chen goes mech.
I don't know if he makes mech here. I think he needs some form of HP. Honestly, a BKB is a pretty darn good idea.
Game losing item.
On Razor, though, you steal damage. You don't need damage yourself.
No, you don't actually use your own damage. You just use your enemy's damage against them.
Radiant's top
so, although I don't think he'll do it first. He might buy like some main, like drums, maybe.
Aqualent to point booster. You think that would be a good build?
Anything with survivability, man.
All right.
That's the thing about Razor is he's actually pretty flexible.
Hello. Lane here. Yeah, TPD. Yeah, he's gonna get Nightmare. Do they have Sentry? No, they don't. Here comes
Razor's
a TPD.
Nyx.
That's a hasted Nyx as well. Demon's they're gonna try to find Demon. He's gonna TP out. They go for TC instead. Here's the Rage.
He's got 8 wand charge.
Trying to get out.
Where's the
he doesn't back? Have his ultimate though.
No, TC.
There's no mana for Zenbach.
All right, 1-for-1 trade. Hasted Zai still going to work, but here comes a Hand of Gone. A little bit late because he just turned level 6. And the Batrider is here. Batrider does have a big flame break if he wants to go for it. The flame break should already kill him, but he's going to go for more. Oh, the double kills is going to come here for Universe. What a net into a Centaur Stomp. Still has a flame break. Can he actually get the aim off? Demon's going to get down to a right click. Here comes TC alive from the TP. He misses flame break? Is that what happened? No, he already hit, but it didn't do enough damage. Excuse me.
Yeah, it's only level 1, so not quite enough. Quickfa. He's doing some draining right now. He's actually got phase boots, so he needs to be a little bit careful here. He's gonna have another imprison here in about 1 second.
Radiant's bottom tower is
under attack. Minus
he's like, you know what? I can heal the creeps, man.
He does 0 damage. Why? Just go home. Wave him.
It's like trying to last him.
Wait, can you stop?
Holy shoot! Look at those hits.
My God.
That's 2 hits. He's got phase. Oh. He's not going up the hill.
I don't think he checked the mana.
Okay.
Nope. There's the old bug reach around.
I have a question. If you attack a creep, like a neutral creep, and you have 0 damage, does it aggro?
Yes, of course. Because you're not even doing
it's
damage.
It's not a matter of the damage, it's just a matter of you being there.
No, sometimes you can attack a creep and not be in range to aggro.
Right. If you're within 500 range and you attack, whether or not your attack even hits the enemy, you aggro them.
Yeah, but in OD's case, he has longer than 500 range.
Ah.
What?
No. Yes.
No.
Does he? I think
no.
He's a 500, right?
No.
You're just saying no to everything.
450. He doesn't have 500 range.
Okay, say it was Morana instead.
They don't. I mean, they would aggro you.
Okay.
No, you have to be within 500 range to aggro. You sure?
No,
I am absolutely positive.
You can attack creeps with Keeper of the Lights to illuminate from miles away and they'll come. No?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm saying you have to be within 500 range of the creeps to aggro the creeps. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I think that's not true.
Because even when you tinker with
Machine
Machines.
Okay, alright.
So you're saying if you stand on your side of the river, if you're standing on your side of the river and the creeps are across the river, you can attack the enemy and to draw the creep wave to you?
No, we're talking about neutral creeps.
We're not talking about lane creeps, we're talking about the jungle.
Whatever. Look, I don't even know what you guys
are. I'm like, I'm lost right now.
I'm so lost as well. Blink Dagger gets picked up on Batrider.
Decent timing, 9 minutes.
Decent, yeah.
Not bad, not bad. I mean, he's got a kill and 46 CS, so... You know, he's not doing terrible. Even PPD is level 6 already.
Here comes a mid gank. Yep, there's gonna be a disrupt into Zai. Perfect setup. Impale, oh, no, he mistimes it though. Count to 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi. Zai mana burns and slow down himself. Alright, that should have been a kill.
Well, a little unfortunate, but I don't think EG are gonna sweat it too much. Killing the Razor is nice, Dire's but they've kinda already got a pretty attack. Decent rotation going on. Although, I don't think they can really push as fast Radiant's as Liquid can push top because they have a chip.
Yep.
So I actually think Liquid might pull out a little bit ahead here. Just being able to get that tower down. You see, of course, having the Midas. Radiant's even gets a last hit on the tower. Fallen. So he's not taking like Dire's the highest net worth right now. Is under
attack. But quite a lot as well.
Yeah.
Dire's structures are fortified.
That's actually pretty good considering how he died in that previous engagement. Had a pretty decent recovery, pretty strong last hitting as well. But here comes mid TP, should be fine. Immediate rage, is it actually going to go on Arteezy? No, there's Dire's bottom tower Prismin, so he wouldn't have done much.
Yeah, it's too hard to try to engage on him when he's alone. Although, well, this here in the back, he doesn't have hook. He's actually getting blocked by his own Chen's creeps.
Mouth.
The rest of the Liquid are like, nah, we don't want to do it.
Yeah, Midas is going to be up on Arteezy after this camp, so... You know, 10-minute Midas is not too bad, considering the fact that he's gone for a boots first and a bottle.
Yeah, I'm considering that he
got ganked.
He actually just walked up into death. Just casually exploring the woods, you know, some...
Oh, TC's dead. Shit.
TC! Put him on the high ground.
He doesn't have a TP.
He can infest and no. Well, how do you actually drag him across, TC? He's gonna rage and fight his way out of there. Open wounds into immediate grip. EG support is so level. Here comes Poipaw. The grave is gonna come through just in time. That's gonna force Batrider to go away. And these two supports, they're out of gas. Not before Zai getting a three-man kill. PPD doing the block, trying to right hit the hook. He was in a perfect position to block the rest of the Liquid member to walk through the path, and he just TP'd out. So pretty big play here from Zai.
Yeah, the unfortunate part is Bulba didn't have mana for hookshot there.
Yeah.
He was like 15 mana short, maybe 20. So instead of being able to stop the TP of Zai and actually get a kill, they weren't able to really do anything, which kind of hurts. Because they, even though they didn't lose TC, which is definitely a good thing, they didn't gain anything either.
Yeah.
They basically just avoided the death.
Yeah, a couple of cooldown, spells and cooldown, that's pretty much it. TC's gonna go on Mason. Mason does have the leap. But there is a face boot, so Mason's winding up.
Clockwork's behind as well.
Well, they do. I hope they have detection. They don't. Immediate back after Moonlight Shadows.
Makes sense to me, man. Don't ever stay your welcome whenever you see that, because you never know how many people could be coming late.
There's going to be Koipaw getting bounced back, and the right click should be enough. The Link, oh, actually draining a ton of damage. Ult's going to come through. Right click from Batrider, sealing the deal. Also have your head. You know, considering the fact that EG is supposed to be on the defensive early on, they're doing quite all right. I think they're doing much better, and I don't think the Lifesaver is going to be able to out-carry this EG squad.
I haven't really seen too much from Chen. He tried the gank mid and it kind of failed. And walking around.
It's actually pretty difficult to Chen gank an OD, because you need the perfect creep since Razor doesn't have any disables.
Yeah.
So you need like either two Troll Summoners, or you need a Troll Summoner and a Centaur, something like that.
Can you not wait until he does his disrupt on you, and then he's slowed down by your passive? And
yeah.
Then
I guess that...
Yeah, but the passive slow scales based on what rank it is, so I think at level 1 it's Dire's actually like a 0.3 second purge, which is like nothing. Like the higher points you get into it, the more it purges, so...
And the Chen was able to bring down tier 1, and now they're actually going for Roshan, sacrificing that T1. They do have, I believe, a medallion. Yeah, Demon has one, so it's not too bad of a trade if they could do it quickly. They don't have the best damage on the team, though, that's an issue. Also, TC's pressuring a tier 1 bot, so I think these trades are actually going pretty well for the team.
Who do you play for late game?
Late game, I would definitely say EG.
Yeah, I mean, your best damage dealer in this case is Lifestealer, and I don't think he could right-click anything. Like, you have to go through all of the spells on EG as well as your own cogs. They do have weave though, so like if you get a good weave off, that could turn things around.
You also have the clockwork bomb, which is pretty good.
You know, you say good weave, but Demon doesn't even have it.
Should be getting it, in my opinion, right about now.
He's level 8, and he has a point right now, so yeah, I guess this is would be where he puts it in, right? He's got 7 points put in, but he has 1 to hold. Dazzle! Is there really a point to getting the 4th point into Poison Touch? There we go. Now he's got his weave. Everything's fine. I mean, I guess Poison Touch does scale and damage in it.
Cooldown
is like 4 seconds lower. 7 second cooldown is actually pretty darn short.
Yeah, yeah. It's really good. It does quite a lot, like the deceiving amount of damage. Tower has fallen.
Alright, so tier 1 given away for free. And EG seemingly taking a little bit of a farm lead here, but I guess it's not really for free, as Liquid take the bottom tier 1 as well. And immediate smoke up by EG. So they know that Roshan was taken, but can they actually make anything happen with their Blink Batrider? Because this is basically their holy form of initiation right now. Because you got to assume a team like Liquid's going to have sentries down, so.
Here we go. They might find themselves a Chen if that's what they want. Centaur could be on point. They have Grave available as well. They're going to grab Chen. Centaur not stopping. Chen's going to get lasso back. Where's the follow-up? The arrow's going to hit, but here comes an angry, angry Lifestealer. That's going to force everybody back. Moonlight Shadow use. Way 2 is safe. But here comes Boba. Boba's got his Blade Mail.
This whole time, right? TZ just farming top, though.
Yeah.
That's how they play, man. You just have, like, 4 people go fight, 1 person farm. That person is typically Arteezy. And he's got a 4 staff already too, so it's like 15 minutes in. Midas 4 staff, not too bad.
Yep, your Quarks is gonna be a lot less effective, your Lifestealer is gonna be a lot less effective.
I think EG are pretty comfortable with the fact that they're not really losing out that much. Like, they still have the tier 1 mid. I think they want to defend this though, because Arteezy already TP'd back. I would be surprised if they let this spell.
Oh. The ward's gonna get dropped down as well. I think that ward is gonna get killed. Here comes the hook on the right side. 4 staff immediately use Blade Mail on Boba. How much more are they gonna get? Here comes PPD. They're all getting focused. Nice block on the arrow by TC. PPD still alive. He has grip, but they are gonna lose him as a result. T5 back and forth. They're gonna just keep running, and that's, I think, it. No, TC wants more
damage.
Yeah, the weave in combination of Razor's physical damage from his ult. Pretty insane stuff. They are gonna get a tier 1 tower. And Arteezy is going to come back, and Arrow will now hit, but Rage dodging one more time. Zai goes into Viz, no detection in lane. They're going to drop one right now. But with 4 staff down, I think they actually can just do a little bit more damage to this tier 2 now.
I mean, TC is a little bit low on life. And I don't...
He doesn't
have a Liquid have an urn? Does Demon have an urn?
Demon does not have an urn. He has a medallion.
Okay, so yeah, they actually can't say then.
I mean, they had an Aegis too, so I feel like that could have been a fight to take. But with that said, Lasso was on cooldown again.
Yeah, and they know that the Bane didn't use grip either, because PPD basically died without doing anything. So if he's alive and you start trying to fight aggressively into a tier 2 when Lasso and grip are up, then you could be in for maybe not so good of a time.
Bad news bears.
So if you're TC here, do you play the tank Lifestealer? Because you know the nukes are going to come to you.
I think honestly he needs to deal a lot of damage very quickly. I think he'll probably just go the route of Basher. I think SNY is also plausible, but I think that like straight Abyssal would actually be really solid, because that way, if you do manage to spot out the Batrider when he goes in, if you can Abyssal fast enough, you can stop him from pulling away.
What about Lincoln's?
Be able to kill. Lincoln's is alright, but Lincoln's is that choice where... I just remember watching an Alliance game where Loda got Lincoln's SNY.
Yeah.
And it's just... Of course, just getting a Lincoln's isn't going to make you do no damage. But I think that people sometimes, they itemize in a way to keep themselves so safe that they actually aren't a threat anymore because they don't do damage.
Yeah, and TC, he does have that Javelin, so we're going to see a Basher coming soon. So here comes the tier 2 push. Looks like EG is just content to at least attempt for a trade. You're not going to defend that. TC in that last fight really showed that, yeah, sure, if you do throw the spells on him, he doesn't really care. And having the Aegis obviously helped with that. Tier 2 being forced to glyph out.
EG have double 4 staff now. Radiant's top tower. So they look a bit grim, boys.
I mean, they have double 4 staff, which is nice, but being able to run from Liquid is one thing, and being able to actually directly fight them is another, because here comes your tier 3, and if you can't fight them defending your tier 3, what can you do?
Well, this is it. This is basically the fight they have to take to blink in, but Universe can't actually get a last, so he's forced to force away. And TC pops the Rage, still has his Aegis. Bulba, though, getting caught in the back. Oh boy, now look what happened. Get the heck out of here. Arteezy moving forward, Mason with the aggressive leap. Demon gets caught, not going to be a lasso this time. Going to be the second one to drop on the side of Liquid. They're trying to re-engage. TC just running back and forth, not sure if he wants to commit or not. Going to toggle the armlet. Way too, also going to be falling here. One more orb auto attack from Arteezy. He gets that kill. Now TC, he's trying to get out. He'll target toggle the armlet one more time.
He's got Aegis, but I
have Phoenix Grip. Yeah, there's no way.
Yeah, I mean, to me, this is actually really poor communication coming out from Liquid because they lost Boba, and then I think the lasso came on Demon, and the entire team turned. Like, I think you just cut your losses and say, hey, man, we lost two hero, unfortunately, let's just go.
OD disrupted as well.
Yeah.
Or OD prison Demon.
Instead of losing two, they lost four, five if you count the Aegis. So
the problem with losing that fight for Liquid is that up until that point, I would say they have a lineup that if it remains like a little bit ahead or even, you're fine.
Yeah.
Which I think they were doing a decent job of, especially after getting the Roshan for free. And it's like, okay, we lose a big fight, we lose an Aegis. Now all of a sudden, taking the next team fight is going to be way harder. They're going to find initiation onto Arteezy. Here's the hook shot. He's immediately banished. Arteezy though, he just gets blown up.
I think he actually misclicked.
He blade mail. He OD ulted the blade mail.
Yeah, and the ult hits even when you're imprisoned.
Yeah.
So the blade mail reflected the damage and just killed him.
So you're saying if there's a Stargate with Boba and he's blade mail in the Stargate,
the Stargate blade mail still hits you.
Yeah, once
with the ult, that's it.
Yeah.
That's some pretty next level sci-fi.
Well, anybody who plays OD knows that.
Apparently, I don't play OD then.
He's
well, it's not necessarily the blade mail. It's just the fact that your ulti hits.
Yeah, no, the ulti hits. I'm surprised the blade mail redirects because you're not on the map. But, you know, that makes
Dota,
sense.
Man. Yeah. I'm taking my pants off in the studio. Chris put my my sound stuff on, or the sound guy, sorry. And it's the things are heavy. And my belt's not on well enough. So I got droopage, man. It's not good.
Look gangster now, though.
I am not, like, even a little bit.
Lumi, give him some tips.
On how to be a gangster?
Yeah.
How to rap.
You don't talk about yourself
I need to get my
gangster.
Street cred up.
Do you know?
No, you don't talk about yourself being a gangster. If you have to say that you're a gangster, you're not a gangster.
No, but if someone else calls you, it's okay.
Yeah. Lumi's gangster. A gangster?
Gangster.
Maybe.
I don't think I'd make a good gangster either.
Probably not. I don't think many Irish people do, to be fair.
You obviously haven't been to Ireland.
You'll have to show me, man.
It's a dangerous place.
I could be made a believer.
So, the problem I have against Basher or SMY, like, basically ways to stick on a single hero, is that that's not going to happen. The sticking on is not going to happen, because the four staff...
RNG bashes can turn fights.
Right. I mean, to me, it doesn't matter if you open runes and bash the same target. If the force staff is going to just come.
Yeah, that's true. So, but I also think that if you don't have any items to stick a target and you just go damage, then you're not going to hit anybody anyway. So it's like saying you're basing an item choice off of the fact that no matter what, he's not going to be able to stick on a target.
Right.
Because what item does he get?
No, you don't stick a target. You just go massive tank. Hard.
But then they just kite you for the whole fight.
Yeah, if there's a lifestealer and you have to waste your force staff to kite a lifestealer around, who's not going to do much damage anyways because of these items.
A heart makes you do crazy damage on the lifestealer.
Well, obviously it does because it's, you know, a strength hero, but obviously you're getting it for the tank and not for the damage because there's better damage items for that cost.
Dire's bottom tower has been denied.
Well, top, here comes Quake, but he's going to get the link onto Arteezy. Arteezy is going to casually TP away. No big deal. PPD maybe not going to be so lucky. Gets bursted down by Way 2 and the Chen creeps.
I'm surprised.
Oh, Zai's walking right into Bulba, but there's a Light Stealer inside. It's a trap! The arrow comes out and TC actually blocks it. Bulba gets a blade mail and try to walk away. He lives with the force staff of the high ground and the help of the wand, along with the Chen heal. Mason, he wants to be
on
the stops the hook from landing.
Universe too
what
good.
What a player, man.
God. Universe is actually too good.
What? Player.
That was amazing.
Yeah, displacement spells do not cancel channel, so you can force staff any channeling and it'll be fine.
If that was Han, that TP was cancelled, man.
He mates as well.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Actually, it's been so long, I really don't even remember. To be honest, it wouldn't have taken that long anyway for me to forget because I'm not so good with the memory.
I think you're better than you let on.
Maybe, but if I have to say that I'm good, then I'm not good, am I?
You say Drasko is good at memory. Don't burst in that shit.
That just sounds awful. That English. So, Zai's looking for a pick, but unfortunately for him, the entirety of Liquid are in the Roshan pit right now.
The second Rosh as well.
Yeah, I think they need to do some structural damage, like AKA close to winning the game in the next 5 minutes.
Objective gaming.
Well, Koifa has a BKB. I think that gives them like a bit of a new lease on life, to be honest, because if you can get a really good link in a team fight, it's still mid game, right?
Yeah, sure.
So you can potentially still do a ton of damage. It's only 24 minutes in.
I just think that they have the best chance of winning the game in the next 5 minutes with this Aegis. Like, if there's no Hubbles,
or at least dealing some substantial damage.
Yeah, yeah. Again, I say getting one Rax is much of the right direction.
I think Razor getting the BKB actually makes TC's life a bit easier as well, because now they're kind of like, okay, do we use the grip on this guy?
Well, the problem with TC, or sorry, with the Koifa going for BKB is, in this point, he's not necessarily doing enough damage to warrant that BKB, unless he gets the Mega Link of his life. Yeah, so
he can get like what 240 damage from that thing if you get max time.
I don't know. They just die so fast that.
I think the BKB was kind of necessary here, but I also think that he wishes he could have just gone Aghanim's, because with their team, I think they're going to have a difficult time going high ground, because the longer the game goes on with the Chen. The Chen's high ground potential becomes a lot less effective because the creeps just aren't that strong. And the third, like the tier 3 tower is the hardest tower to take, right? So, with that being said, I think that if he doesn't have an Aghanim's, even if Liquid win a fight, we'll assume that EG are going to start saving for buybacks pretty soon, right? Because they only have one tier 2 left.
Yeah.
So, I think it's going to be pretty difficult for Liquid to actually just straight up win. I think they're going to have to take a series of good fights in order to win.
Well, Universe is looking for a pick. Gonna run straight into Boba. Do they have a setup of any kind? They're gonna drag him right back to RTZ. RTZ's gonna immediately disrupt one. The hook is gonna come through. They have a gem on the Lifestealer.
Dire's bottom tower
he's nowhere
attack.
Close.
Yeah, I think he wanted to go for another hook, but Koifa walked in front of him, and he used his Force Staff cogs first to make sure that if RTZ did Force Staff, that he would still have hook to catch up. So, I mean, he did the right thing there, but I think there was just a little bit of miscommunication because Koifa was just like, yep, I'm walking in front of you.
Yep.
And then life was tough. And he was stickied as well, so he couldn't turn fast enough to, like, reposition.
Ooh, they're going to find the Batrider again. Force that forward, like you mentioned, the open rune's going to seal the deal. All right, without the Batrider alive for 45 seconds, you go for that tier 2, but EG already at the tier 2 top. So at best, it's going to be a trade. And I think EG right now with the positioning might push a little bit quicker. You see that Zai's cutting off the creep wave at the back. They could now force tier 3 and force EG to, excuse me, force Liquid to come back quicker.
Yeah, this is one of the dangers that you run, like, the longer the game goes against a team. In my opinion, like, Morana is a way better split pusher than a Razor can be, because the Razor basically excels around fighting, whereas Mason has gotten items that pretty much give him damage and wave clearing potential. Excuse me, yeah, Mason. I was like, wait a minute. Why did I say Mason? I was like, yeah, it's Mason, okay. I'm fine, this is fine. Yeah, he's got a Maelstrom and he's got a Yasha and drums, whereas Koifa just goes BKB drums, right? So Mason can split push a lot faster than Koifa can.
There's also the recognition of the fact that they needed to split push. I mean, just to summarize the last minute, they lost a Batrider, but they gained a tier 2 and they defended their own tier 2 just by saying, hey, we need to push top. So it was pretty good play.
Yeah.
I think Bruno was trying to mention that we're going to see an Axe Scepter attempted on Koifa. Because I don't hear Bruno.
TC finished Abyssal Blade as well.
Yeah, the Abyssal's pretty big. If you can Abyssal somebody and you don't either get Fiend Script or that hero doesn't get banished or Force Staffed, you pretty much kill it, right? Now, I mean, that's a lot of stuff to hope doesn't happen.
How many Force Staff we're looking at? Three? Three Force Staff and a banish. So there's like four ways to save a hero.
And two blinks on EG as well. And the thing about Astral Imprisonment is that if you have a Blink Dagger, you can guaranteed blink out of it.
Yep.
It's the last 4 seconds.
Farm that thing.
I'm just like, I'm so bad at blinking out of things like Phase Shift and Astral Imprisonment because I always try to blink in a different direction than I'm actually facing. And then somebody has like Rot or something and I just get like...
Yeah, force us to think about it though.
Yeah.
The GG lights came on in the studio.
That's true. GG any minute. Yep. 8 to 6, 28 minutes in.
I mean, like I said, they need to do something now. Here comes a infested clockwork that is also smoked up. Sees a pick up top. I mean, if Arteezy gets hooked, he is straight up dead.
Yeah.
Oh, really, I see it. That's the LGD trying to hook. He finds it. Here comes the bash. They're going to get RTZ dead. And RTZ, does he have buyback? No, he does not.
Go, go. Boys in blue.
Okay, I got to ask, what makes that an LGD hook? Incoming.
Remember Boba? He was finding all the hooks like that. All the Chinese guys were trying to stay in the trees.
Them. Yeah. I thought you meant... Okay, I totally misinterpreted what you meant. All right, you're right. You know what, man? Well, you're right, you're right. Right. Mason's going to be forced to leap out.
But bot, though, but pressure from the Batrider.
Oh, yeah. The infamous split-pushing Batrider.
Look, man, all I'm saying is he's hitting a tier 3.
80 base damage.
He's not doing bad.
Literally hitting for no damage. Oh, TC, though, he's going to get a bird down here. He's going to respawn. But still, that's a very, very big kill for EG. Still 20 seconds left on our TZ. TC's gonna respawn. Immediately gets lassoed. The rest of Liquid have to follow this up. They cannot let BZ just die in the base like this. The Fiend's grip on top of everything, and there's no lasso. The Flame Break knocks Demon too far away. He couldn't get it off. The Bulba Cogs actually trap him inside of the base. That is not LGD. Koikfa wants the heck out, and he will indeed be sent home by the Chen. Mason gonna go down to the test of faith. The Rocket was there to help as well. The Nightmare disjoints the Impale from Zai, but it doesn't matter. The Hex, way two goes down. That base defense, that was Flame Break by Universe was disgustingly good.
Universe carrying his team right now, because that was 5v4 with RTZ being dead throughout all of that. No buyback. Lasso to start things off.
Bulba. What rank of Grave does Demon have? Because I'm pretty sure he was... Grave. Yeah, okay, so that's what, 700 range or something? Yeah.
This is why I'm not a big fan of maxing Poison Touch.
Yeah. If he had max Grave, he would have been able to get TC, but would it have changed the fight?
I mean, I think TC might have actually mauled at one a true person, but no, they would have. They were too far in. They would have been dying to RTZ when he TP back.
Man, Batrider is a pretty good hero, guys. What other hero in the game can defend a 4v5 with an Aegis and pull a hero so far out of position that your whole team has to come help you?
Magnus.
I mean, to be fair, they didn't have to help him. They could have just left him there. But the Batrider still did his job, right? Which is single-handedly stop them from pushing. Like, that's basically what Universe did. He's like, okay, nope, you don't push.
Yeah, it's a Batrider, but again, it's also that... well, I want to say the push on the bottom, but it's not like he got much out of it.
Well, it did like half damage to the Terra.
But also the other big thing is the fact that Mason was able to burn the Aegis with a good arrow. So if they didn't burn the arrow, I mean, you could lasso him back, but he's going to come out with a vengeance, so...
Well, the thing is, if you get lassoed into tier 4s before your Aegis
he's going to rage! And he's going to go to town.
But there was still grip, that's the thing.
Yeah, that's true.
Like, between the lasso and the grip, if you get pulled into base, even if you have your Aegis, it doesn't matter. Because as soon as you get up, you're going to get gripped.
Are they going to find Universe?
Rock it on!
In the trees.
Stay in the trees!
Staying in the trees doesn't work against Boba, man.
That's true.
He finds you in the trees.
Oh, and that was a gem, by the way, on TC that they got. I forgot to mention. I'm not sure if anybody else did. But
Batrider has it now.
Yeah. So Universe has a gem. Coming in. Which is pretty terrifying, actually. So good luck having any wards in the map, basically. I think Liquid have one right now.
Yeah, on the high ground.
Yeah. His eyes just scuttling around, just looking for somebody.
He hasn't died, by the way.
Yeah, he's played a really solid game. Ooh. I think, honestly, like, the games today have been a little bit slow in terms of kills, but I feel like all the teams have had potential to fight. You know what I mean? Like, except for the last game, I guess. That game, I really don't feel like VP had much of an option to fight. I think it was kind of just like... didn't really have strong lanes. Things kind of fell apart from there.
Alright, Finish Axe After, I imagine, is coming to Koifa.
Alright. Is that going to be enough?
No.
I think he's going to have a very hard time staying alive long enough.
But this does give him the siege power if they want to now start sieging with their ultimates.
Yeah. I mean, the nice thing for Koikfa is that they are focusing so much attention to TC that the whole purpose of Razor is to try to be alive as long as possible, which I think is, in all likelihood, going to happen, right? Like, because if they dump everything on TC, Fiend's Grip, Lasso, Arrows, you know, RTZ hexing him, whatever, then he can get a good static link, his ulti will be ticking for a while, he'll do a reasonable amount of damage in the team fight. But that also means that one of your highest farmed heroes is never doing any damage. Like, poor TC has just not really had that good of a game, even though he's very farmed.
Yeah, we are going to definitely need some magical stuff happening from Boba, as well as infested TC to actually make this work. I don't think they could just walk up the ramp and say, hey guys, we're here.
Our TZ just bought a BKB as well, so that makes life pretty hard.
Now, there is going to be one point in the game where I think Liquid has a better shot of winning than now, which is when Razor picks up his refresher. That's when I think they could... Because
no, he doesn't.
Oh, Murano ulti. Oh no, TC. Mid. Oh no, not again. The four stat hex. TC is going to be a great time. No, Universe with the lasso, but the grave goes off anyway. TC going to have to invest inside of Bulba. Here comes the stun from Zai and the flame break as well. And it does not look good for Liquid. Already two down so far. TC has the BKB pop. There's a Fiend's Grip as well on a TC. And it looks like almost a five-man wipe. Quick on forward treat. Has the BKB buyback from TC as well. They want to try to reuse this, but I don't think they're going to be able to get anything out of it.
Koifa would have died if the banishment did not actually arrow. Not going to hit there. Also, Koifa's got to be extremely careful about how he's using that plasma field, because he can definitely get stunned by Zai, and the rest of EG is moving so fast.
Yeah. I mean, TC is just always, like, because of his hero, he's pretty much the only one outside of Bulba who's going to be on the front lines ever. So it makes it really easy for a team like EG to pick him off. Like, behind Batrider and just a Hex, like, he's always the one in the front lines. This is one of those situations where I think if you're even trying to fight, you have to be infested in Bulba before you go into a fight.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you're just going to get CC chained. Like, there's no other way.
All right, here comes the smoke. They're going to go into the Roshan pit under the enemy wards. Oh no! Oh, demon, he was smoked. Okay, he's fine.
Oh, good, baby.
It's good, it's good. It's warding. If they can sneak this Roshan, it's Aegis and cheese, man. Pretty big deal, but here comes
Mason.
No, it's scouted. It's scouted.
It is scouted.
Demon cannot get caught, man. His weave is really important.
There's no Sammy's Eclipse. There's no Fiend's Grip. They're going to find Demon straight away. TC, he gets hexed inside of the pit. Bulba comes in. Nice hookshot. Cog only get a hit on PPD. The Link still draining them from Quick. The 4-step of the high ground from Arteezy. He's going on TC. TC actually almost going to die. Manages to armor toggle the damage. Now Quick taking a little bit of damage himself. He's even in feeble. TC eventually does go down to die. And Mason gets a kill on way two as well. The third to drop is going to be Bulba. And here's the Fiend's Grip. Just came off cooldown for PPD, and it's a full team wipe in favor of EG. Holy for holies.
A lot of damage from him.
EG are just playing the fight so well. Like, every single time they go in, TC barely gets to do anything at all. Like, he just sits there and he's like, okay, I'm hexed. Arteezy hexed him straight up, like, as the fight started. I think Bulba hesitated a little bit too long on his cogs, because even if you trap yourself in with Arteezy, at least he's getting drained the whole time, right? And yeah, then you don't let two heroes just walk away from the team fight, because TC was going to die pretty much no matter what. So at least you're not saving TC. Let Quickfa get more damage, right?
Dire's,
so I don't know. I feel like it's still hard, Dire's just given Liquid's lineup, to try to fight that. But I do feel like they might have been able to win it.
Well, with the fact that Demon died from the get-go, it's basically 5v3, because you know Chen is not really contributing much. Like, you need a weave on either the entire enemy team or your own team. You need Grave, because TC just basically died from all the residual AoE damage. He's just going to get a free Rax. And I think that, again, they either have to solve for till refresher on Liquid Koifa, or the game is not going to go anywhere in their direction. There's a basher on Mason, so the game, at least in EG's eyes, is over.
Well, I mean, Abyssal Blade isn't necessarily a bad thing against a Lifestealer.
I guess you leap in and just Abyssal?
Well, it's not necessarily just for leaping in either. It's for when the Lifestealer tries to go on you.
You a bastard.
Because if you're a ranged hero and you're out of escapes...
Oh, Zai's gonna find kills in the ending. Okay.
Okay, got him. Got him. What was that video where it's like Lina misstun into ulti? That's pretty much what that was. Zai, though, he's gonna force staff out of the cogs. Bulba on the chase. Does not have
free TP scroll there.
Should have picked it up.
Yeah, man. 135 gold.
I think
Andy, he's going back for it. He's like,
no, he's going for a kill. Andy, I think that was Shitty Digest episode 1.
Yeah.
I don't know why I know that, but
yeah, Enigma's Shitty Digest. That's what it is. You're right.
And then
wait, two. Universe is here. Mech pop. Lasso though. Rip.
Oh.
Auto attack.
I feel like that ulti was a bit optimistic. Like, I'm getting ganked. Ulti!
All healed.
It's all better than that ult when your carry dies and then you're like, oh, all healed!
Like 3 seconds after.
Yeah.
I tried, lag.
So, is there any way that Liquid can get back into the game? Like,
fresh rags?
Are we talking like a perfect team fight has to happen? Is the refresher a necessity? is there a way for them to win?
What I was thinking was if they got the Aegis and he had refresh rags, then he could just go up on the high ground, die, and still do the ulti damage when he's dead.
Does that actually work?
Yeah.
Yes.
Holy cow.
It's like when you're dying with Spare Bear, your bear is still alive.
Yeah.
So basically for like 5 seconds, you're just like...
Yeah. Blowing shit up.
You're like Skrillex, just freaking going ham inside of their base.
Yeah, okay. That was my game plan, but then they didn't get the Aegis, so...
Yeah, that, that kind of pressure...
Refresher is also the game plan, which he just doesn't have to go for.
Worry about that. Oh, what the hell?
Demon gonna get exploded here. Mason as well, stuck inside the car for the time being. Getting forced out, has the cheese.
He's got Abyssal.
Doesn't have Leap though. He's gonna Abyssal, still has Manta up if he needs to use it. Gonna pop it eventually. Arkeezy just going ham with the BKB activated. Now Koikva just gets exploded. And well, that's game. I think that about sums it up.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
I gotta say.
Radiant victory.
I feel bad for TC, man. Like, he farmed extremely well, as he always does, but his hero just didn't leave him any room to do anything. Like, if he wasn't infested inside a Bulba before a fight started, he was just either hexed or fiendscript or lassoed, and EG just did such a good job at shutting him down that he could have had, like, a 10,000 gold net worth lead.